Just hold on. Promise me you'll consider these points before you go ahead and buy Procreate, because they are super important to whether it's right for you or not. All right, let's start with the fact that I absolutely love Procreate. It's my favorite, most used app, and it is absolutely fantastic for my needs. That's what today's video is all about. We're going to cover some pros and cons of Procreate and why it may or may not be right for you when you are looking at buying this app. By no means is this a paid video. I just wanted to give you a few tips and some things to consider before jumping in. All right, let's jump straight in with a pro. And off the bat, the smooth workflow that Procreate offers is probably one of its biggest pros overall. It's no wonder that Procreate is so loved all around the world, because it is really intuitive and easy to use. And that really does mean a lot when you are talking about a digital app and digital workflow like this. There are definitely apps out there on the market who do not do a good job of this, but Procreate thankfully do a fantastic job of keeping things nice and simple and therefore very, very smooth. And that leads me to my first con of Procreate, which is there is a little bit of a decent learning curve when it comes to people who are not used to digital workflows and drawing apps like this. By no means is this a reason that you shouldn't get Procreate. Just so you know, there is a little bit to get your hands around, but luckily channels like mine and so many others out there give you so many tutorials about this fantastic app, ways to use it, and tips and tricks to go further with it. Let's jump straight back into a pro, and that is the highly responsive brush technology as well as the brush library. Overall, Procreate do one of the absolute best jobs on the market of creating not only one of the best ranges of brushes straight out of the box for you to use. They also do a fantastic job of what you can actually do with those brushes and how they interact within your canvas and the art you're creating. This is one of the best reasons you should pick up Procreate, because it is absolutely miles ahead when it comes to these brushes and this technology. Let's look at the next con that I have on my list, and that is no vector. Now, this is something that's probably not going to bother a ton of people out there, but anyone who does want to use Procreate professionally for certain different areas of digital design may notice that the lack of vector could limit you a little bit when it comes to creating the type of artwork you need to create. Personally, I do have to rely on other apps like Affinity Designer, which luckily does the job for me. It is a little bit complex in its user interface, but overall the features are there. But please keep this in mind when buying Procreate. You will not be able to do vector yet. I do hope this comes in the future. So Procreate, if you're listening, vector would be fantastic. The next pro that I want to talk about kind of leans into the first one that I mentioned today, and that's the intuitive workflow with customizable options. I talked earlier about how smooth the workflow is, but the fact that it's so intuitive and you can play around with it for a little bit and figure out where everything is and nothing's really too deep or hidden in there, I think this is a massive benefit. You also get a really great range of pre-made canvas sizes, as well as the option to build your own. Now, some do find this a little bit limiting, but I have heard in the very near future, Procreate is looking to change this with an update coming very, very soon. So watch this space. The next con we're going to talk about today is masks. Now, this is really interesting. I've made a lot of videos on masks and the use of them on this channel, but the con here today does come from when we do want to use them in a bit more of a professional workflow. Overall, they still are rather basic. You can't create a mask from a selection and have it actually paint the areas that you want to conceal, and you can't invert a mask or detach it from the layer. Now, there are workarounds for all of these, and I have made videos on this channel about how to use the different types of masks in Procreate. Hit the link at the top of the screen if you do want to check those out. But overall, if we are talking about using masks and you might be used to something like you would have seen on Photoshop in the past, this is something where Procreate could definitely step it up a little bit. Please keep this in mind if you are looking to buy Procreate and possibly want to use masks heavily in your workflow. Let's jump straight back into a pro, and that is Timelapse Recording. This is one of my absolute favorite settings. If you've ever viewed my channel before, you'll see that I post a lot of my artwork, and the way that I can post that really effectively and show you the workflow is through these amazing time-lapse recordings. By default, these happen automatically in the background, but you are able to change these settings as well and have them record at higher resolutions, which is really great if you are like me and want to share those with the world. Back to a con, the next one is hidden features and customizations. Now, I mentioned the ability to customize before, but the reason this is coming in as a con is this is kind of hidden in Procreate, and there's nothing really when you're using the app that tells you, hey, go and use these. There are channels like mine and, again, many others out there who do share this with the world and show you how to customize these, like gesture controls and all these other great little tips and tricks. But for me, it's a little bit hidden, and I really feel like if there was something in Procreate which showed you and encouraged you right from the get-go, this could be a massively important part of people's workflows. So for me, it does come in as a con, but it could definitely be easily rectified. Another pro for me is the format options when you are inside Procreate. Current formats we can use are PSD, TIFF, PNG, PDF, GIF, and JPEG files. Along with this, we've also got the ability to export as Procreate files, which is really great if you are working with another artist or want to share it between iPads. You're going to be able to keep all of that layer structure set out like you've created it in the app itself. I also love the ability to switch things into CMYK mode. If anyone's ever printed things on a professional level before, or even printed things like stickers, you can know the importance of some companies needing their artwork in CMYK. And we also have the option to save simple animations as MP4, which is going to be fantastic to be able to see simple playback straight on the iPad itself to see what they're going to look like before we either use them or share them. And we have time for one more pro today, and that is no subscriptions. This is absolutely massive. In the world we live in, with subscriptions every single place we turn for every single app, it's really refreshing and encouraging that Procreate know that they have a fantastic app and they're going to keep offering it for a really affordable price, and then it's yours for life. I bought it about 8 years ago and I've never paid another cent for it, and it's absolutely fantastic. No subscriptions is probably the biggest pro that I can mention today. And there we have it. A really great list of pros and cons. And depending on who you are, some of these pros could be cons, some of the cons could be pros, but these are the ones that I think are really important to mention and that should influence your decision when you are looking to buy Procreate. Overall, you definitely won't regret it for what it is. It is a really affordable price for something you can get in, experiment with, carry it everywhere with you on your iPad, and just have so much fun creating. Procreate also made a big announcement recently about Procreate Dreams, which is coming this November. If you want to see me break down what that's all about, hit the link at the top of the screen here. But apart from that, if you like today's video, hit that subscribe button down below. It doesn't cost you anything, but it does help me continue to make these videos each and every week. So until the next video, I'll catch you then.